Let's bring in John Harwood. John is CNBC's chief Washington correspondent. John, good to see you, sir. Let's start with the basics here. Potentially, how big of a deal is this? What might General Flynn be able to tell the special counsel?
It's very significant, Craig, and I think it indicates that there's serious legal jeopardy for the President of the United States. The underlying issue that Bob Mueller is investigating is, did the Russia interfere with the U.S. election with the cooperation of the Trump campaign? And if so, why? One of the questions is, was the Trump administration suggesting that they might eliminate sanctions in order, in return for help from the Russians? And Michael Flynn lost his job over lying about his conversation with the Russian ambassador. So this gets to the very core of what the case that Bob Mueller is pursuing is. There are peripheral things to that. Paul Manafort, the campaign chairman, was indicted for conspiracy and issues related to money laundering. But the underlying purpose is to go after this Russia connection. And Mike Flynn, if you're the national security advisor to the President of the United States, you don't get much higher than that.
And John, I've been talking to sources overnight. I know you have been as well. The official line from President Trump's legal team is that this is not a surprise and doesn't necessarily mean anything larger. But if you talk to other members of his inner circle, there is some concern. So how much concern is there within the West Wing right now?
I think there's a lot of concern, and despite the statements from Jay Sekulow and others, we've seen reports that President Trump has been comforted by optimistic readings from the attorneys about how this investigation is going. I suspect they're going to change their tune after this, because prosecutors do not give do not accept cooperation from defendants unless they think they're going to get something significant. And so the idea that Michael Flynn is either now actively cooperating or negotiating to cooperate indicates that he's told them that there's something significant that he can help them with, they look for people higher up the chain. There's only one person higher up the chain than the national security advisor, that's the president.
And John, as you know, when the president, when Republicans get back, they want to get tax reform passed before Christmas. It's a very tight deadline. To what extent does this overshadow the president's agenda and that effort?
Well, it's certainly going to cast a cloud over that issue, but I do think that Republicans have their own reasons to try to push forward on tax reform. Don't know if they can get the votes to do it. It's a very controversial, not very popular bill if you look at public opinion. But if Republicans believe that their own survival depends on passing this bill, I think they would be able to set aside Donald Trump's problems, although it does darken the landscape.
CNBC's chief Washington correspondent, John Harwood. John, thank you.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.